So we're supposed to be conformed into the image of Jesus Christ. And why is that? Well, Jesus is the expressed image of God the Father. And the Bible tells us to imitate God. Well, if we imitate Jesus and he's the expressed image of God, guess what? People are going to not only see Jesus in us, they're going to see God himself in us. Amen. Well, and we talked about the fact of a little boy walking around behind daddy at a rodeo, a rope and a cutting. And he looks like dad, acts like dad, talks like dad, walks like dad, dresses like dad, wants to be dad, and wants to hang out with dad just because he loves daddy so much. Just wants to spend time in his presence. That's how we should be with God the Father. Amen. Now, Jesus gives us this commission in Matthew chapter 28. Remember we talked about it 2 days ago, and Jesus said, all power and authority has been given to me in heaven and earth. Now you go and make disciples. Well, how are we going to do that if they don't see Christ in us? Well, then we saw in Acts chapter 1 verse 8 that Jesus said, and you shall be endued with power from the Holy Spirit, right? And then we'll be witnesses. So there's a power that's available. And yesterday we talked about the anointing. We saw that the anointing oil removes burdens and destroys yokes that Satan tries to put on people. Well, and then we saw Jesus in the synagogue teaching, and he said, the Spirit of the Lord God is upon me because he's anointed me. For what? To heal the brokenhearted, to set at liberty those who are in captivity, to make the lame to walk, the blind to see. All these different things that he was supposed to do. And then he closed the book, he sat down, and he said, today, this scripture is fulfilled in your hearing. He was saying, look at you guys, I am this person who is anointed by God the Father with power. Amen. Well, now I want to pick it up someplace here, because look if over here in John, and it's chapter 14, and it's in red letters, guys. So this is Jesus speaking. He says, most assuredly I say to you, he who believes in me, the works that I do, he shall do also, and greater works than these he will do, because I go to be with the Father. Well, how in the world are we going to do that? How can we do greater works than Jesus Christ himself? We can't do it without that anointing. That's what Jesus was saying in Matthew chapter 28. He says, now all power and authority has been given to me. I'm giving it to you, and go in my name. Well, if you pick up in Mark, now this is, again, what we read was in Matthew, but if you go into Mark, it's the same passage, but what we find in Mark is this. Hang on, I'm getting there. Chapter 16, Jesus says, go into all the world and preach the gospel to every creature. He who believes and is baptized will be saved, but he who does not believe will be condemned. And these signs shall follow them that believe. In my name, see, there's that power and that authority when we go in his name. And see, he trusts us with it, because if we truly are children of God, then we know the will of God. Remember, because we've had our minds renewed to the things of God. We talked about that last week. And so he says, in my name they will cast out demons, and they will speak with new tongues. They will take up serpents, and if they drink anything deadly, it will by no means hurt them. Then they will lay hands on the sick, and they will recover. Now, again, there's been some craziness where people start handling snakes and drinking poison. I don't tell you to do that. What Jesus is really talking about, many times when he talks about serpents and scorpions, he's talking about demonic influences. Well, he tells you and I that that's been placed under our feet. See, many times we don't really realize this, but Satan is a defeated foe. Jesus Christ already dealt with him. You and I need to live this victorious life. The Bible says in 2 Corinthians chapter 2, it says, thanks be to God who always leads us in triumph through Christ Jesus. Why is that? Because our foe is defeated. Now don't get me wrong, he's still alive and well on earth, and he's still trying to deceive, to still kill and destroy from you and I. But we need to recognize that he is defeated, and Jesus has given us power and authority over him. But you and I need to be brave enough and have courage, and not walk in fear, but walk in faith and start speaking the things of God over our situations. And that's what Jesus is saying here, greater works shall you do. Now, again, many of us get so caught up in signs and wonders and miracles, man, we want to lay hands on the sick and cast out devils. Well, what about walking in peace? Jesus walked in peace. What about having compassion and mercy for other people? What about loving the unlovable and forgiving the unforgivable? That's all part of this power. That's all part of this anointing too, because we're commanded to love our enemies, to do good for those who hate you, to pray for those who despitefully use you, to bless those who curse you, to forgive the unforgivable. That takes power, my friend, and that comes from that anointing as we put on Christ and let Him live His life out through us. Hallelujah. What a victory. What a God. Amen. Hey, I'm Keith Brown. This is Tack Room Devotional. Remember, we love you. Jesus loves you. We pray that God would richly bless you as you diligently seek Him and serve Him.